It is a pleasure to speak to you and to tell you about what we've been doing very briefly over the past year, the year 2018. TrustAfrica has, on the whole, done quite well. Our programs have all been functioning. We've got major activities, convenings, training journalists, workshops to train journalists, and enhancing their capacity to report on various issues, developing new partnerships, a much greater engagement with the regional organizations of this continent. And all that has happened in the course of the past year, thanks to your support, thanks to the support of those who have been funding TrustAfrica, thanks to a dedicated staff who have been working tirelessly to make sure that we deliver on everything that we committed to delivering on. So this message is a thank you message to all of you for your support. I'd like to thank those who have been funding TrustAfrica in particular for providing the resources that have enabled us to do the work that we did. We look forward to continuing the relationship and making it stronger and having much closer collaborations with all of you in the course of the coming year. We are in the process of developing a new strategy for the next 5 years, which we hope our board will approve in its February meeting. And it is a strategy that will carry TrustAfrica's work forward and take it to new levels in every sense, in terms of the professionalism with which we've been working, in terms of the ability to work with civil society and to play a leadership role in the civil space on this continent, our ability to engage with the policymakers and the policy communities at various levels. And it's a program, therefore, that will help civil society of this continent to respond to the challenges that this continent is faced with. We will be presenting it to you when it is adopted by the board. I'd like to thank the board in particular. Madam Aisha Bajalo has been a great chair who's led this foundation for a couple of years. And she, under her able leadership, all that has happened, all that has been able to be achieved was with her as a leader of the foundation, as board chair. Extremely committed, very wise, sharing her wisdom with us all the time. I would like to thank the members of the board whose term ended in the course of the past year. I'd like to mention Natalia Kanem, who is now with UNFPA. Thank Bishop Maluzi from South Africa. Thank Karim Tazi from Morocco for their great service to TrustAfrica in the course of the period during which they served as board members. Special thanks to Jerry Salole, the founding chair of the board, who stayed on all these years as a member of the board, and who also stepped down in the course of this year. We've got new members on the board as well. I would like to welcome them. Abdoulaye Diagne, former Executive Secretary of the UNECA, United Nations Economic Commission for Africa, and Director of the board member of the Mo Ibrahim Foundation, and Bongi Mokabela from the Nelson Mandela Children's Fund and Nelson Mandela Children's Hospital in South Africa that she helped to establish and has been leading for many years. We are very proud to have you with us, and we look forward to working with you. It's been also good to announce, to see, and to get Kumba Ture as the new chair of the board of the foundation, taking over from Aisha Bajalo. Kumba is a writer, she is an activist, she is currently one of the co-coordinators of Africans Rising. And she lives in Senegal and has been a member of the board already for a number of years. I'd like to thank my predecessors, Dr. Akwasi Edo, who is the founding executive director of TrustAfrica, who actually built the institution, and Dr. Tendai Murisa, who is my predecessor as executive director, and Dr. Fouad Abdelmoumne from Morocco, who served as an interim director during the year of transition. I'd like to thank the staff one more time and thank all the partners we've been collaborating with in the course of the year, and wish you all a very, very happy year 2019.